Welcome to the Simon Micro Channel and to a question whether hot dogs, wieners or frankfurters are made from skim milk powder. The answer is no. Then, however, there is another question as to whether any experiment had been done to use milk powders as a meat replacement in these products. Now the answer is yes. In the past century, when a great part of milk fat was made into ice cream, there was a surplus of skim milk and a question, what to do with it? 50 years ago, an objective to develop a hot dog imitation from skim milk powder had been assigned to me as a new 40 years old researcher with no experience in dairy technology. The new product had to be looking, smelling and tasting as meat-based hot dog, and it had to be less expensive. No sophisticated texturization had been permitted. The goal had to be achieved by simply heating milk slurries. The milk powder, a technician, and a water bath had been provided with a 5-year term to make a delicious hot dog substitute. So, heat-induced milk gels had been produced and scientific papers on the effect of various factors on their firmness had been published in the American Dairy Journal. The milk gels, spiced and colored, smelled and looked like the hot dogs, but their mouthfeel was horrible as they had no texture. An electron microscopist was asked for help to compare the structures of my milk gels and meat-based hot dogs. The trouble was in the detail. The milk gels were composed of balls rather than fibers making the hot dogs. I was eager to immediately use electron microscopy in my work, but it was strictly rejected with an urgent order. Work harder, intensify the gelation, and have the product ready in 1974. Electron microscopy showed that the tiny balls called casein micelles coagulate into clusters, but they never make any fibers. The project had not been feasible. Yet, not a single experienced dairy scientist offered support by telling the management that globular milk proteins cannot be converted into meat-tasting products by a primitive procedure. I started suffering from a severe depression as my technological failure threatened my research career. Then, one day, my director tormentor had been promoted and a new director from the food industry had cancelled the hot dog project. He supported my intention to study milk and dairy products by electron microscopy. My life had changed and so had my career into a very happy one. Interestingly, without the several years of suffering from severe anxiety and failure, I would have never experienced the great joy of doing meaningful research. Scanning and transmission electron microscopes have been used because they are more powerful than optical microscopes and they make it possible to observe objects at a nanoscale. With the support of 4 colleagues in the United States, a specialized food structure journal had been founded in 1982. It contains the first large crop of research papers from all over the world in the new discipline of food structure studies. Its demise in 1993 was mourned by many food microscopists. A review paper entitled "The Beauty of Milk at High Magnification" and other papers on food microscopy have been published in the InFocus magazine of the Royal Microscopical Society in the United Kingdom. My research findings used to be shared on my website since the arrival of computers. Then, at my age of 89 years, I made my first YouTube video on electron microscopy of milk and dairy products. The SciMed Micro Channel contains several videos on the microstructure of foods which may interest you. The coronavirus pandemic has terminated my rewarding research work of a scientist emeritus. The irrational project on making hot dogs from skim milk had been forgotten, but without it, my life would have been very different. Thank you for your visit.